Extraordinary, isn't it? Jamie Lee Ross has finished his speech by congratulating a minister who rang the police to intervene in a case of an assault of a man upon a woman. That's what Jamie Lee Ross has just done. That's the standard of the National Party, to get up in this House, Mr. Speaker, and to defend a Minister of the Crown for going and intervening in a case about domestic violence. I think the actions of Maurice Williamson were disgraceful. Maurice Williamson has been in this House for 27 years, and he should have known better. And what's interesting to me, Mr. Speaker, is that with the standards of behaviour of ministers in this national government, John Key likes to crow and say, you know, I've come down hard on this. It's only when they're caught out.
And caught
out. It's only when they're in a corner and he has to move.
That's right.
It's not a high standard. It's just when he's been caught out and then suddenly he says, right, let's make sure that this doesn't happen. Let's try and shut this issue down. And consistently, over the 6 years of this government, that is what has happened. They are not high ministerial standards. They are not the standards John Key told New Zealanders that we would be getting under a national government. What they are the kind, what it describes is the kind of behaviour of a government that thinks it's above the law, that the rules don't apply to them. The rules that apply to other New Zealanders don't apply to them. Maurice Williamson can pick up the phone and call the county's Manukau superintendent. An interesting call to make, I might add, Mr. Speaker, given that the county's Manukau superintendent actually wasn't in charge of the case. So I'm not quite sure why Maurice Williamson rang him. Perhaps it was because Maurice Williamson thought that that was somebody he could influence, somebody he could use his ministerial power to say, are you on solid ground? This person's given a lot of money to New Zealand. And that's the second thing that marks this national government out. They think they're above the rules and they're out to support the wealthy few. How unbelievable that someone would think that ringing the police to say this person's given a lot of money means anything at all. What it means is it speaks to the values of the National Party. It speaks to the values where money talks. This is all about the donations that the National Party receives from wealthy New Zealanders. Money talks. If you donate money, you're in a different category. The rules don't apply to you. So the National Party ministers think they're above the rules, and they think that people who have money are above the rules. They will do anything to look after the wealthy few in this country, and it is a disgrace, Mr. Speaker. And it is all about the donations that the National Party get. Mr. Liu donated $22,000. In the case of Oravida with Judith Collins, we now know that they have received around $85,000 from Oravida over the last few years. The relationships between the National Party and big business in this country are way too close. What New Zealanders want, Mr. Speaker, I believe, out of a government is that they will treat all citizens fairly, that they'll give everybody a fair go and everybody an opportunity. But with the National Party, be it an individual person or be it a business, it's the money that matters. It's not the person that matters. Judith Collins is still a minister. Maurice Williamson isn't. How can that be, Mr. Speaker? Yes, Maurice Williamson crossed over a line and he deserved to go and he resigned. Judith Collins has consistently misled this parliament, misled New Zealanders, misled the Prime Minister about her activities in relation to Oravida Limited. That is bad enough, Mr. Speaker. Any other minister would go. And David Cunliffe mentioned it today. Nick Smith went as a minister over writing a letter of support on ministerial letterhead for someone he knew, something he should not have done. Judith Collins, on a taxpayer-funded trip to China, orchestrated three events for her husband's company, Oravida. It was a trip about justice issues. She got rid of a justice event so she could go 30 kilometres away from the airport to visit the headquarters of that company for a photo opportunity. An opportunity which official documents show was to increase the profile of that company. That's a breach straight away of ministerial standards. But in addition to that, as we have rehearsed many times, Mr. Speaker, she also then orchestrated a dinner where the directors of Oravida and an unnamed Chinese border official were present. Let's be clear, that dinner was a meeting. It was a meeting that was prearranged 5 days before she left New Zealand. It was a meeting that worried and concerned the New Zealand ambassador to China and the head of the North Asia division of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade so much that even after Judith Collins changed it from being an official dinner to being a private dinner, they still wanted to provide her a briefing. And Judith Collins gave it away in the House today, didn't she? When she said that she told the New Zealand ambassador the day after the dinner that nothing untoward occurred. Well, why would you need to tell the ambassador that nothing untoward occurred at a private dinner? The ambassador was concerned that something untoward was going to occur. No doubt that's in the notes that he provided for her. And she felt the need to say that she had nothing untoward occur. He actually, the Ambassador Carl Worker, in the information that MFAT have released, has quite clearly distanced himself from this dinner. So that, Mr Speaker, is a minister on a taxpayer-funded trip on justice issues who orchestrates three events. She also got them invited to another event, their directors invited to another event in Beijing, while she should be talking about justice issues. And she remains a minister, and Maurice Williamson has been sacked. That's double standards. It's not just low standards with John Key of ministerial behaviour, it's now double standards as well. And this government, Mr Speaker, is accumulating the impression in the minds of many New Zealanders, and we've all heard it in the last week. It's who you know that matters with the National Party. It's how much money you've got that matters with the National Party. It's whether you've donated to the National Party that'll get you influence, that'll get you inside the door. That is an affront to our democracy. That is against everything that New Zealanders believe about an egalitarian society where everybody gets a fair go. There's no fair go under this National Party. The way they've gone about their business, be it with Sky City or be it with Rio Tinto or wherever it is, indicates the kind of cronyism that they favour. But it's in these personal actions that we see the true colours of this national government, the true colours of a government who will always put money before people, who will always favour the wealthy few, and where the standards that John Key told us that he would apply to his ministers have dropped to an all-time low. Mr Speaker, I want to refer briefly in that context to the actions of Judith Collins in relation to the press gallery, because they fit very much within this. Maurice Williamson resigned. John Key said he should have resigned. Judith Collins was the person left defending Maurice Williamson the other day on Sunday. In doing so, she drew into debate a member of the press gallery and that person's family. That is one of the lowest things I have seen a minister do among many low things in this term of government. It's the kind of behaviour that again speaks to the fact that anything goes with the national government if you're not one of their friends. It was petty, it was vindictive, it was deliberate, and the apology that Judith Collins has made was for a mistake. Mr Speaker, this was not a mistake. It was a deliberate act consistent with the way that the National Party is going about its business. Let's take out people who dissent from us. Let's change the law so you can't protest. Let's change the law so the Canterbury Regional Council isn't elected. Let's change the law so that students and staff aren't on university councils. Let's silence dissent. It's bullying. It's nasty. It's vindictive. And that is how this government has ended up. A government for the wealthy few that thinks it's above the rules and that has now no standards within its ministerial system. Maurice Williamson has resigned. That was the right thing to do. Judith Collins should follow, and John Key should face up to the fact that his government is now representative of the very wealthy few in this country and not all New Zealanders.
Louise Upston.